Hey guys, this is Matt here, and about 2 days ago, I got this diaphone sharpener from DMT from a local hardware store, and it's really neat because it actually has two sides. We have a coarse side, which is blue, and we have a fine side, which is red. I think this is 600 mesh, and this is like 325 mesh. I could be wrong. I really don't know what the mesh means. I'm sure that has something to do with a grit like sandpaper, but I'm not totally experienced with freehand sharpening, holding the actual stone, but we're going to try it out. This is actually a kitchen knife that you can get from Sam's. It's made in Brazil, but it says it has a stain-free high-carbon blade, and you can get a pack of these for $12 at Sam's Club. And I found them to be actually really nice in the kitchen. I mean, it's not, $100 chef's knife, but if you're just going to throw it around like most people do, it's a great knife. You can actually sharpen it up and put an edge on it. And as you can see, it's dull, except for maybe the tip. But we're going to make sure it's dull. I'm not going to go real hard because I'm going to try to sharpen the knife in a relatively quick time. But that's a swipe over the coarse side. And barely anything going on. And I know a lot of my subscribers are really experienced sharpeners. So if you have any tips about sharpening with this, just feel free to comment. I love you guys' comments. They're very informative. They're very educational. And I think this is going to be a great part or a great piece to put in my Maxpedition gear kit. So when I'm out and about, I have something to sharpen with. Maybe I can't get a fine hair-popping edge with this thing, but I definitely believe if you're out in the woods and you're going to have something to sharpen, you definitely need something coarse in case you run into like a rock and you have small deformation in the edge, and you can actually get that deformation out with a coarse stone and have cutting ability. Let's see what we can do. And again, I'm not really experienced with sharpening like this, so we'll just see what we get. Okay. I definitely have a burr, which is, I didn't need to remove that much metal, but definitely for someone that's inexperienced, having a burr on one side is a good thing to note. Now I can go to the other side. And you want to be careful. This probably isn't the best way to do it. I could probably actually switch hands and do it like that, because if you do it like this, there's no guard and you could actually slip up and hit your hand. But I'm just going to be careful. I wouldn't recommend this to a person who's never sharpened before, because you could actually end up hurting yourself really badly. Let's see if the burr's gone. Okay, the burr's gone from that side and it's transformed to this side. So definitely this coarse stone is removing a good bit of metal in a rapid time, which I like for field sharpeners. Because if you're stuck out in the wilderness, or perhaps you're traveling and all you have is an ultra fine stone, if your knife becomes extremely dull, you're going to be sitting there for a while. And if you have a coarser stone, you can get a lot of work done. So let's go over here. Most of the burrs switched over again. like this butterfly knife style handle, because even though I have a short sharpening stone, it's not like a bench stone. My hand is relatively far away from the action of the blade. So although there's no guard, say like a sharpening steel has a guard, I still feel relatively safe. I wouldn't necessarily recommend this to someone that's a beginner, because they might hurt themselves really badly, but I'm definitely enjoying the experience so far. And it feels like we have a pretty consistent bite. And that's just the coarse side. Let's see what will happen with the paper. Wow. And that's just with a coarse stone. And I was trying to sharpen a knife at my dad's house the other day, and it was a less quality kitchen knife than this. And like I said, this is actually a really good kitchen knife. It comes with a pack of four for around $20. Or $12, I forget which price. So let's go to the fine. Let's see if the coarse can remove hair. I feel it pulling, but it's not doing much. So let's try the fine side. Probably something I could have done with that coarse side is just decrease the amount of pressure I was applying to the stone, and perhaps I could have got a hair-popping edge, but like I said, I'm not really experienced at this, so we're just going to move to the fine side and see what we can do. I'm going to try now to actually put somewhat of a micro bevel on. So instead of going at this angle, I'm going to raise it up slightly and see what we can do. I'm going to decrease the pressure now and go a little bit slower. Let's see what we can do now. It's slicing just fine. A lot of factory knives out of the box couldn't actually do that.
At least Kobolds.
Yeah. And, okay, so now we'll try some lick here. And, it's not really... It's barely getting in some hair, but that's probably just because I'm not really experienced freehand sharpening. Now, if I took this knife as is and went up to my Spyderco Sharp Maker with ultra fines, it would probably shave like nothing else. But just as far as a field sharpener, I mean, look what I can do with it. That's more than enough work. In fact, the crappy kitchen knife at my dad's house, after I got done with the coarse side, I got some free-hanging rope, and I actually severed the free-hanging rope with a really inexpensive kitchen knife. So I know this knife could sever some free-hanging rope, and it can cut some phone book paper. And I imagine with a little bit more experience and hopefully some helpful tips from you guys, I can get this knife shaving sharp with this alone. So thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.